Hi children, good morning. Now let us see some values here. Root 2 and root 3. I explained about this already in the introduction of rational numbers. Just see how to get the values of root 2 and root 3. Here see, root of a number. How to find out any number in this method only. To find out square root of any number. In this method only. I will explain later what is the root, what is the square root, like that. Just to see what I am doing here. After that I will explain you. Okay. How to do the square root 2 and square root 3. How to get the values. Here see. 2 means 2.000000, like this we will write. Okay. There is no problem. Here first start with the 1. Because 1 square is 1 now. The nearest square for 2 is 1 only. So, 1 ones are 1. 2 minus 1, 1. After that, here what is the quotient? 1. Multiply this with 2. 1, 2s are 2. After that, what we have to do? With the same number, we have to multiply and write in the ones place of this number. Here. Here, 1. Point is there, point. And 1 into 2, 2, with under 2 zeros we will take down, 100 it became. So, 2 places we have to take it down, because it is a finding of square root now, 2 places we have to take it down, 100, it became 100, here 4 you keep, and again keep 4 here, here what you are keeping, that number only you have to put there only, there also, in the quotient also, in the quotient also, we have to keep the number. What is the number that is in the divisor? That number should come in the quotient only. So, 24 into 4, 96. After that, minus 100 minus 96, 4 came. Again, 2 places take down. It became 400. Here, what came? 14. 14 to the 28. Again, 28. After what number we have to keep means same numbers in ones place of this divisor and in this quotient same number we have to keep and both we should multiply and take down here. 281 into 1, 281. After that it won't go. If you take 282 into 2, it will become more than 400. So that's why we are keeping 1 here. 281 into 1, 281. After subtracting, we'll get 119. After that, take down those 2 places and next, continuing in this process, we'll get 1.414 and so on, repeating. That means, just observe this decimal value. Square root of 2 is 1.414 up to 3 decimal places we are taking, but if we want to continue the division, it will continue. But there is neither terminating nor repeating decimals. Neither terminating nor repeating decimals are there. So, what about this value called? What this value called? Neither terminating nor repeating decimals are called irrational numbers. Those type of numbers are called irrational numbers. Those numbers cannot be written in the form of p by q. Where p, q are integers. So, this is the finding out the method of root 2. This is the method to find out root 2. After that, root 3 also. In the same manner. See here. 3.000000 we have to keep like this. After that, nearest square, 1. 1 ones are 1. 3 minus 1, 2. Next here also, keep that point. 2 places, bar we have to keep from right to left. Here after 2 place, 1 place only is there, no? So, take 3 only. If here some another value, then we will take both 23 like this. So, here only 3 is there. So, 1 ones are 1, 3 minus 1, 2. After that, multiply this with 2. 1 into 2, 2. Here 27 into 7, 189 came. If we put 8 here, it will go more than 200. So, it, we cannot subtract. So, 27 into 7 we have to keep here. and 27 into 7, 189. 10 minus 9, 1. 9 minus 8, 1. So 11 is there. After that, take down two values, 0, 0. Afterwards, keep 3 here. And 17 2s are 34, we have to keep here. After that, what value we have to keep here? That value only keep there in the quotient also. Here in the divisor place, in the quotient place, same number should be there. So after that, multiply those two values, 343 into 3, 1029. Like this, we will continue the division. What we got there? 1.732 and so on. This is also neither terminating nor repeating decimal. So root 3 value, we will take up to 3 decimal places as 1.732. Here, children, observe one thing. These are the irrational numbers, root 2 and root 3. There is another definition for irrational numbers that I told already. What is an irrational number? The number which we cannot written in the form of p by q, that is called irrational number, where p, q are integers, q not equal to 0, that is called irrational number. What is next definition means? Neither terminating nor repeating decimal is called irrational number. The decimals which are neither terminating nor repeating, those are called irrational numbers. So, this rational and irrational numbers combinedly together are called real numbers. What are they? Real numbers. This rational numbers and irrational numbers combinedly together are called real numbers. Now let us see how to write the real numbers. Understood, children? I hope all of you understood how to do this square root of a number. For any number you can take. Suppose, for example, find the square root of 24. Root 24 also we can do in this method only. I am doing, just observe. 24 keep like this in the box. Next, which square is nearer to this 24? 1 square 1, 2 square 4, 3 square 9, 4 square 16, and 5 square 25. So, 25 we cannot take. Less than 25? 24 is less than 25, no? So, take 4 square. Which is nearer to this number? 4 into 4. 4 for the 16. Like this you have to keep. 14 minus 6, 8. So, 8. After that, keep point here. If you want in decimals, we have to take points. 24.00, like this if you take. Next, 4 to the 8. Here take down 2 zeros. Next, here what number we should keep? That number only we should keep there only. Suppose, for example, 6 8 6 into 6 6 6 are 36 6 8 are 48 36 6 8 are 48 plus 3 51. So more than this number also we can take. For example, 88 8 8 are 64 8 8 are 64 plus 6 70. Okay, up to this only. I think if you take 89 into 9 and 81 9 into 72 plus 8 80 801 more than 800. So take 8 only. 4.8 88 8 sir. So now multiply these two. 88 into 8 8 is 64 8 8 is 64 plus 6 70. Like this we can find out the square root of a number, 96. That means 4.8. Square root of 24 is 4.8. Up to 1 decimal only. If we want up to 2 decimals or 3 decimals, depending on the question, we have to take the zeros after the decimal point. Understood? Here see, nothing is difficult here now. Once you, if you observe carefully, it is very easy. First, we should understand 24 lies between which squares? 4 square and 5 square. First take 4. Less than 5 square, no? So take 4. 4 for the 16. 24 minus 16, 8. Take down those 2 zeros. So if we want one place means 2 zeros take. 2 places mean take another 2 zeros, 4 zeros. 3 places means another 2 zeros, like that. Depending on the number of places in the decimal part, we will take the zeros. Okay? So here, like this, we can find out square root of any number in this method. Understood? Okay. Irrational numbers and rational numbers combined together are called real numbers. Real numbers are nothing but union of irrational and rational. Rational and irrational, both are the same. So here I am representing in some picture type. Assume that these are natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers. Okay, that means in rational numbers all are there, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, all are there in rational numbers. Next to irrational numbers separate. So these two together combinedly are real numbers, R, capital R. These two combinedly together are called real numbers. Another way of representation is R is equal to Q union Q dash. This also we will write. So come and tell me children, I am giving some numbers. In which group they belong? That means in which set of numbers they belong? Let us try to recall in which set they belong. Minus 2 by 3 belongs to Q now. This is the rational number. So minus 2 by 3 belongs to Q. 0 belongs to Q. Minus root 2, irrational numbers, Q dash. Irrational numbers are represented by Q dash. Minus of root 2 belongs to Q dash. Like this, if I give any number, you should be in a position to recognize in which set they belong. Okay? I hope you understood this one. These two combined together are called real numbers. So, in real numbers, what numbers are there? Natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. Both combined are called real numbers. Any number you take, that is real number. Okay? Up to 10th class syllabus. Any number you take that will come under real number. All numbers can be represented on real number line. So they are called real numbers. So up to now you learnt about up to rational numbers, representation of rational numbers on number line. But representation of irrational numbers on number line also possible. We can represent irrational numbers also on the number line. How to represent irrational numbers on the number line, we will see now. Okay? See children, how to represent irrational numbers on number line. That also can be represented on number line. So, because it is a real number now, we can represent on number line. Let us take one example. Take the example of root 2. How to represent root 2 on number line? Example, take. Locate root 2 on number line. On number line. How to locate root 2 on number line? First, draw the number line. In the middle, 0. After that, positive number. Right of the 0, positive. Left of the 0, negative. Take 1 unit on number line. 1 unit of distance, that is 1. After that, this is x-axis we will call, that is horizontal line is called x-axis, and vertically take 1 unit distance. This is called along y-axis, that will come in the geometry. Now you take vertically 1 unit distance. this is called O, this is called A, this is called B. Otherwise here O you keep, where X and Y meets, that is origin. Here A, this is B. So here 1 unit distance, here also 1 unit distance. Okay. AO is 1 unit, OB is 1 unit. AO is equal to 1 unit, OB is 1 unit. Is it clear, children, after this? So, AO is 1 unit, OB is 1 unit. Join AB. AOB is a right angle triangle. AOB is a right angle triangle. Vertically we are taking now from here. This is horizontal line and vertical line. They meet at one point. Here right angle is there. AOB, if AOB is a right angle triangle, what is the property of right angle triangle? Hypotenuse square is equal side square plus side square. This is the property of right angle triangle. According to this property, AB square is equal side, one side AO, AO square plus OB square. AB square is equal to, what is AO square? 1 square. OB square? 1 square. That is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. If AB square is equal to 2, what is AB? AB is equal to root 2. This will become plus or minus root 2. But here it is a distance. A and B. Joining A and B is a distance, no? So, only we take positive value, plus root 2. So, with the distance root 2, if you draw an arc, it will cut the x-axis between 1 and 2. It will cut the x-axis between 1 and 2. Taking the distance AB, with the compass, keep the center as O, and draw an arc through B, it will cut the x-axis at one point, that is the root 2 value. Like that, we will represent root 2 on the number line. What we have given root 2 value previously? Through squaring root of a number, to find the root of number, we learned already. So, what is root 2? 1.414, up to 3 decimal places we found. So, here at that place, the curve cuts the x-axis. So, this is the location of root 2 on number. In this way, we can do. See once again, on the x-axis, that means on the horizontal line, from center O, from the starting point 0, take 1 unit distance. After that, vertically from that point where one unit ends, from that point, take OB as 1 unit distance. Join AB. So, AOB will become as a right angle triangle. According to the property of right angle triangle, find out AB distance. And taking that AB distance as length, taking the AB distance as radius, draw an arc by using a compass, keeping center at A. If you draw like this with the compass, it will cut the x-axis at one point between 1 and 2. So, at exactly 1.4, it will cut the x-axis. That is the root 2 position on the number line. Like this, we will locate root 2 on the number line. In this way, we can find out root 3, root 5 also. Root 4 is 2 only, no? 2 we can easily represent. So, the irrational numbers also can be located on the number line. This way. Okay, children, is it clear for you? Okay. First, you have to know what are the rational numbers, what are the irrational numbers, difference between them. After that, location of rational numbers and location of irrational numbers on the number line. After that, what are real numbers? Real numbers are nothing but combination of rational and irrational numbers. Next, we will locate real numbers also on the number line by successive magnification method. Year numbers means all the terminating, non-terminating, repeating, decimals, everything will come. Terminating we located. Non-terminating and repeated decimals, how to locate them? That we will do in the next classes by using successive magnification method. Next, some more important concepts are there. Surds. That is the surd. What is a surd? What is the exponential form? What is radical form? All this we will know in the next classes, coming classes. Okay, children? Bye.